So I've mentioned before that electricity is dirty, but how dirty is it? Well, it depends on where it was made. If it was made in a fossil fuel power plant, like a coal power plant, then it's going to be quite dirty. If it was made in a renewables plant, like a wind or a solar farm, then it's going to be quite clean. And this measure of how dirty your electricity is, it's called carbon intensity. And all electricity has this number. The electricity coming through your wall socket right now has this number. And it changes by region. If you're in a region where most of electricity is created through coal power plants, your carbon intensity is going to be high. If you're in a region where most of your electricity is created by renewable power plants, your carbon intensity is going to be lower. But also, interestingly, changes over time as well. When the wind's blowing or the sun's shining, then it means that there's more energy being created through renewable plants, which means that your carbon intensity is lower. But when the wind stops blowing or the sun isn't shining, utilities have to make up the difference by burning more coal or burning more gas, which increases the carbon intensity. And that's why carbon intensity is the third principle of sustainable software engineering. Consume electricity with the lowest carbon intensity possible. Which leads to a really, really interesting use case, which is called demand shifting. Try running your workloads at times or in regions where the carbon intensity is less. And what's really exciting about this approach is that without changing a single line of code, just by making a decision about when and where you're going to run your application, you can reduce the carbon emissions of your application.